So some pieces of my hair with this headband right now is just like, whoosh, just doing what it wants and has a mind of its own today. So we're gonna ignore that. The bedhead said drama, woke up and picked crazy today. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? We got a quick little video today featuring some products that TikTok made me buy. So this is TikTok made me buy number 3, makeup edition. So we're not doing a specific technique today. There's just some duo, some new products, some possibly ginormous sponges that I really wanted to see. They were worth it. Test them out for you guys. For those who aren't on TikTok, this is mainly how the TikTok videos go. Someone recommends you something, they show it to you, you want it, you know, but in like 15 to 60 seconds formats. But I'm gonna give you all of them today. And we can sit, chat, and chill, whether you're folding your laundry or on your lunch break, whatever have you. Hey girl, let's spend some time together. I have my brows on, and that's about it. I actually did a little faux tan Sam moment, and it doesn't look dramatic. It's my usual medium from Isle of Paradise. It's cute. I even did like 2 drops of the facial serum just because your girl was super winter. Like, I'm still pretty fair right now, but I mean, I was losing my yellow undertone, it felt like. I was like, what happened? Well, what's going on? Like, that kind of year probably is. So we're not in like in summer shade foundation or anything like that, but we got a little color to her. And when she got some color, she's feeling good about herself. First thing we're gonna work on is our base. We're gonna be wearing the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream, which I have reviewed, and using this ginormous big old sponge from Sonia Kashuk. It's under $10 at Target. I wanna say it's like between 5 and 7. I don't even remember, girl. I just picked it up yesterday. I don't think it says it on the box either. So it's their body sponge. You know, I'll put a price tag on screen of the actual price. I got y'all. And it has a sharp edge right here, while the rest of it's just your standard round beauty blender. I did do a side-by-side of it dry and wet for you all next to a beauty blender, both being dry, both being wet or damp or however you want to call it. She's really, really big. You can see that. Huge. The TikTok in question right here, she is saying that it's really, really, really fast. So a lot of people are doing their bases like, I didn't know we were doing that. I didn't know that was like super essential. I get it, saving time. We got places to be, people have jobs to go to, you know, class, etc., etc. I didn't know that was aggressive, but of course it's a bigger surface area. I assume she's gonna blend us to perfection in a timely manner. Will I be possibly doing a timer on my phone and comparing to see if I can do it just as fast with a small sponge? Maybe, but remember, this is affordable and it's huge. If you wanted a large accessible blender, then this is already a good idea. Did I just open my calculator app? Maybe, but this is all for, you know, ish and giggles, so no big D. So she applied this to her face first, or whatever base product she wanted to use that day, and then we're gonna just aggressively but productively blend out. I'm gonna get my stopwatch going, we'll see how it goes. She's damp. 1 extra squeeze. Okay, not too damp, we don't want too damp. 3, 2, I'm so nervous. 1. All right, so that was just short of 16 seconds. That just rounded up to 16 seconds and say that was one side. Of course, we're not like doing the concealer, I think same exact side. Most people use the butt of this blender, but that's really, really huge for me. I've always favored more of the flat side because I can just get around every edge really nicely, but we're pretty blended. Of course, we're gonna really look at the quality of the blend versus the speed. That's really why we're here. But just for, you know, scientific reasons, this is how someone who's been on YouTube for 12 years test if they can blend their foundation as effectively as she thinks she can. Okay, same thing, classic beauty blender. We'll see. 3, 2, give me a 1, go. I'm actually faster with the smaller one because I'm just so used to it. But I don't think it's gonna save everyone's speed. So if you're like thinking that your makeup's gonna be done in 9 seconds, then you know, let's be like realistic, it's just really fun how big it is, and you can obviously use it for, you know, other areas of your body. It still does fit well in the inner corner, as people have mentioned. So if you do feel like you have the need for something this large, she was the last one at my Target, so I grabbed her because, you know, everything that TikTok recommends sells out for a few months. So this is what we got today. Now that we've just done our speed racer mode, I'm gonna put a little bit more on each side because I would want to build a second layer, and I'll use Sonia Kashuk sponge. Longtime viewers know that my first beauty sponge was a Sonia Kashuk sponge, and I lived, breathed, worshipped. I want to say, was it light purple? I think so. So back in the beginning of my YouTube days, I started junior year of high school. I could not afford this beauty blender. Obviously, as I got older, I was like, okay, and I understood the hype, but it wasn't like the Sonia sponge wasn't good. I loved my Sonia sponge, and this now discontinued foundation by Maybelline that was in a pot, the Dream Mousse, not Dream Mousse, Dream Smooth. It's a whole different one than what's available now. It was the best. And guys, Stila recently released something similar. It's not getting the best reviews, but every time I see some sort of cream pot foundation, whether at Sephora or the drugstore, I'm like, memories. And if you remember the red bedroom, my teenage bedroom with that sponge, then you've been around for a decade. Yeah, you can feel old with me, but thank you so much. So that's our second layer. Keep in mind, the CC cream is a buildable cream, so the first layer was gonna look like that no matter what, because it's supposed to, you know, start off with more of a lighter coverage. We went a little bit more today, and I think we're looking pretty good. The color match is amazing right now, thank God, to my faux tanness. Jeez, if you haven't seen my review, you can go check it out. This is in shade 330W. While we're here, we'll just do a little bit of concealing and contouring before moving on to our other items. Again, this is a really just casual video. We don't have anything too crazy. I actually have already shown you guys two of the products in separate videos, one being the Ardell Aqua Lash, which if you guys haven't seen that video, then you can go check it out. She ended up deserving her own review for many reasons, but that was highly recommended from TikTok as well. And then the NYX Shine Out Loud Duos, those basically, you know, transfer proof liquid lipsticks from the drugstore, new releases, that also got its own video. So we're a little short-handed, short-staffed today, but we still got things. I figured, why not do our concealer together, get some really good shape, and see how applicable the sponge really is. I'm actually using the KKW concealer in shade 5. I haven't used this in forever, but we're blending, and I can really get along the lash line, and it's not painful, which is nice. And I feel like we're gonna get some good nose shape out of here. It's kind of hard to turn it around. The butt side is like smashing my whole face in, but the density isn't super super soft. I feel like a little denser than the e.l.f. sponges, the e.l.f. like camo sponge or its purple sponge, but not as dense as Real Techniques. It's still pretty soft, similar to Morphe with like a click denser. I don't feel like it feels anywhere near similar to the beauty blender. Like, I feel like it's a little softer. Yeah, softer than the beauty blender. This line is about to be sharp AF because we got such a long tip. It's already given us some dimension already, but in the words of my mama, I want more. So I'm gonna be using the Oma Beauty dual ended double take sculpt and strobe in Honey Honey. She looks quite scary when she goes on. I'm just gonna do some swipes up the cheekbone and then put her down, blend her out. I'm using the same spot where our other concealer was on to help blend. Oh yeah, that's shape, baby. Ooh. I've got a few questions if I would go a shade lighter in this. And honestly, if you are like super winter me, super winter twinsy, then sure. I don't find a problem with this if I'm anywhere near like my standard like medium natural beige. I think this would be fine. But if I was any lighter, then sure. It actually just looks more intimidating before you blend it. And you can of course blend like a concealer over it, and oof. She's a fan. She's a fan already. A little on the double chin. Send her home. I'm gonna twist out a little bit so we can do our nose. The stick is a little big for the nose area, so I try to be careful. Here we go. The dot, again, throwing me off, but that's actually pretty centered. Just like round thing. I'm gonna try this round thing out. It doesn't look cute though. All right, blending quite quick. You could totally draw on some abs like this. Can it do the fine detail work of a nose contour? Kind of got everywhere. Using the bottom to kind of clean that up. Now, if we highlight the middle, we might be able to get it blended in. It's not the perfect nose contour shade because it is a little more apparent when it's in the middle of my face, but with a dry brush, we can make it a little bit more subtle. Okay, there we go. That's the nose contour of the day. I'm gonna lay some under eye powder down and then we're gonna move on to our next product. I don't think I've seen anyone really do anything but their like base and concealer. I haven't seen anyone use this powder yet on TikTok. I'm sure there are some, but it hasn't come up on my searches. Oh God, totally just poked myself in the eye. But our under eye concealer is set. And I'll blend the rest of it out. Since we're gonna be working with cream blush, I didn't wanna do too much in that area. I wanted to leave, you know, the hydrated finish. And then if we wanna do more like powder later, we can. So the next thing would actually be from Rare Beauty. I haven't tried their newest releases. I'm not on the PR list. So your girl ran over to Sephora and snagged two of their new products. The first one being more of a liquid eyeshadow. This is in shade Nearly Neutral. And I think I picked up Nearly Neutral in both. So we are gonna have a monochromatic moment. This is the Stay Vulnerable blush. She is a cream blush. The eyeshadow looks just a little bit lighter, but who knows how they apply. And they're both from the same Stay Vulnerable line. So you can't really see when I'm holding it, but the liquid eyeshadow has like a mailbox shape to it. It's sharp and flat on one side while the other side is rounded. It's quite interesting. So I saw this TikTok where she's like, Rare Beauty, you got me. And she's blending it. She doesn't work with liquid eyeshadow often, she said, and neither do I do it on some rare occasions, the Glossier being one of them. And I really liked it, except for, you know, it didn't have the longevity I wanted. And I was like, color so pretty. So we got the same color from the TikTok and I'm gonna try it out. So I'm gonna work it around with my finger. Feels pretty good. And then use a little bit of a brush to kind of shape it and try to make sure to blend the edges out before it's set while not losing too much color. Obviously there's probably a little bit of a learning curve, like how much you need to apply, how fast you need to blend. That's pretty color. She's doing something. Do I have the real estate eyelid wise to be doing the same looks as other people? No. But we doing it, attempting. So I did three tiny dabs. The applicator is a very, very small lip gloss applicator that has a flat bottom, or flatter bottom, shall I say. We're gonna try only brush on this side and see if it changes how it sets or how it spreads. This is also my good eye, so. They dry to really nice powder finishes. They're not sticky. They feel like nothing, absolutely nothing, not even powder. It doesn't feel like anything from my eyelid, which is kind of magical compared to other cream eyeshadows. This seems like it would have decent longevity. And of course more if you wanted to set it, but I don't think that's what I'm going for or we are going for today. How do we feel? So I do like the light wash of color. I would probably still want to highlight my brow bone with like a cream shade. I'm using just dry brushes right now that have nothing on it to see if it changes anything. And I kind of want to go back for like the lash line area just to intensify that spot just with a dab each. Okay. Maybe two swipes, because I lied. Take a flat brush and just pat her in. And then back to our blending brush, just towards where it meets in the crease. Okay, Selena, I see. The points were made, the research was done. I feel like this eye doesn't look as even as this eye just because of the eyelid situation, but we're gonna use the same under eye powder and just put that on the brow bone and see if that helps. I think I'm gonna have a final thought section at the end of the video. So we're gonna move on to the Nearly Neutral blush. Do we have any instructions on here? It's supposed to be a breakthrough formula, delivers a weightless wash of soft focus color that melts upon contact for second skin finish. So it has a little dip in the pan and it makes me just wanna sink my finger into it. So I think we're gonna just try that application. Ooh, she is quite creamy. Hopefully she's not gonna kill us pigmentation wise. They said it was soft. I'm gonna place it on the back of my cheekbone. It is the season of cream blush. So let's see how this goes. Soft, pretty. You can take the blender and just lightly pounce the edges. I wanna try it with a brush on this side. Kind of a dense yet fluffy situation. Also from Sephora, this is the 99 brush. She has a little forgiveness to it without being too wild. I wanna see if it changes how pigmented or how focused the product is. It's blending beautifully, literally just tapping her in. Wow. I see Rare Beauty trying to win best cream blush 2021 coming right out of the gate in January. This is really, really nice. More forgiving than Fenty for sure. Not as patchy as the e.l.f. one, at least on me. Points were made. I see. So the next thing we're trying is the new Maybelline Sky High Mascara. I've gotten a couple requests. This is the waterproof formulation. So Asian lash friendly, short, straight, sad, looking at the ground, kind of shy lash friendly. I do not have a lash lift right now, so I'm going to curl my lashes. This is my Shu Uemura curler. Still my favorite after many years. I've repurchased it so many times. It fits my almond eyes really well. I've tried other Asian brands. I think I've tried Shiseido's and it unfortunately pinches my lids a lot. So she's the gal. And then I use Kevin Aucoin when I'm trying to blend lashes together. So you can see the difference between the red and the black because Kevin Aucoin opens a lot wider and that's great for that. But when we're just doing our itty bitties, just a few squishes from Shu, and you still can't see my lashes. Granted, they're kind of still suffering from their experience with the Ardell Aqua lashes. Just saying, don't miss that video. Just for the sake of what my lashes used to look like. Are these good curls? No. They're not, but this is what we got. This is part of their Lash Sensational line. I love Maybelline mascaras. They are my favorite from the drugstore. Maybelline and L'Oreal always release around the same time, and I usually favor Maybelline's releases 9 times out of 10. And they're affordable, they work well. They've rarely let me down. So the brush we're working with is a little bit longer. She's a little tapered towards the tip and it is a plastic bristled, short, spiky separating brush. So I'm not gonna expect volume because usually on these brushes it's more for lengthening, but we've seen and heard good things. I feel like I need to get a business card out because I'm gonna jack up my eyelid, but you know how some people do the tops and the bottoms? I don't have enough lash to do the tops. It's actually physically impossible because I will just run it along my whole eyelid instead. It's not clumpy. So when you see the TikTok, everyone has actual really long lashes in comparison to mine. Not like super long, not like oh my god, but definitely more blessed, definitely a little bit more of God's favorite when it comes to the lash department. And I understand that, and that sounds like everyone has a realistic expectations on itty bitty lash committee over here. So I will of course judge it as I would any mascara in my experience, but it's not gonna do the exact same thing. While other people who have more like straighter lashes but more length are gonna get a different effect, if that makes sense. A lot of people have lashes that you can't see but they're pointed downwards and they got some length to them, man. They got some length to them. They don't know how bad it could be. I almost considered going to get a lash lift just for this video, but I was like, well, it's waterproof, we don't need to do that. We're also gonna ignore just the effect of mascara behind on the eyelid. We're gonna clean that up after the mascara dries. Since we're here, I usually would, if I'm just wearing mascara only, put liner in my waterline to give a fuller lash line effect. A little less bare and a little more focused. One eye is watering, but ooh, I can hear my lunch, aka Chris coming home. All right, so now I'm taking a dry detailed brush and just trying to get off that extra residue without messing up the lashes too much. Okay, coat number two. Layer one has definitely dried because I can feel more of that like resistance when you meet the first layer. She does have a good amount of equal volume to length. And as you can see, it is holding a curl. Does it look good on my lashes? Like everything else? No, it doesn't, unfortunately. Not built like that. It's giving me medium clumpage. Nothing too bad, not super transfer-y either. I do have a lash comb, so I'm gonna try my best to comb it out. So you can see the curls held when you look at like the side angle. It's just not what you expect from it. It's not a bad mascara at all. It's pretty good as far as curl transfer and an equal distribution of volume and length. It's just not flawless. I'm not in love with the brush. It's just average to me. So right now I'm gonna go with an average Maybelline mascara. Not a bad one. Hopefully it stays that way. We're gonna do the lower lash line too. Rare Beauty actually has this tiny little mirror, so thank goodness. I'm trying to figure out if this is more of a wet or dry mascara, and I think it's really right in the middle. Because even on the lower lash line, I'm getting a little bit of clumps. Not like the lashes sticking together, but just little like dots on each hair. Like it's not applying like super smooth liquidy. It does a little something something that you'd want to like comb out any uneven spots. I should mention that I have this in the waterproof brownish black. So the black is probably way more intense. Not that I thought that would matter too much, but that one was quite sold out everywhere. So I ordered this from Ulta a week or so ago. It took a little while to get it in here, but we got her. She originally was on Amazon first and I didn't know if like it was worth trying prior to TikToks. So after TikTok hype hit, of course it sold out and we snagged what we could. All right. Last but not least, and something I'm probably, yeah, the most excited about would be a lip combo from NYX Cosmetics. I'll put the TikTok right here where she is sharing her very, very popular lip combo, which everyone has been trying on and it's looked really good. So I did roll up to Ulta the other night to pick it up. It is a combination of the Nutmeg lip liner and their butter gloss in the shade Fortune Cookie, which is probably the nudest, like most Kim Kardashian, like light peachy nude shade. This liner was the only one that was sold out right above the display. There was like a bag of three and Chris noticed them and he was like, yo, it's right there. Like, are those them, you know, type of thing. Cause they were supposed to be totally sold out and obviously they were just gonna restock it, but they left it on the top of the display in a pile of like loose ones. So just keep your eye out. Its number is 811. And I actually wanna see if this looks like any other lip liners I have just in case we need an alternative, but this is very affordable. Both of these together, I believe were $9 total. One's five, one's four. I think the liner's four. This is possibly one of the darker lip liners you guys are ever seeing on me to date. You guys know how NYX seals off all of their products with like Saran wrap, you know, the clear packaging, the Easter basket packaging. It's such a pain on the lip liner. So I crushed my lip liner twice in my hand because the top kept popping off while I was trying to pull off the thing and it would like run on my hand. So the shape might not be exactly how it comes stock because I had to sharpen it, but it's open and we got her open. It's not a bad lip liner, but it's not the creamiest. So you gotta take your time. Medium level creamy. So she did fill in the majority of her lips. So when you're going through TikTok, you might see two different versions of this. So this is with Nutmeg and Fortune Cookie. There's also one with Nude Truffle, which is a similar color, which I saw a few left of, and then one of their lipsticks that are similar to this color. So whichever one you want to try, this is the one we're trying today. I have both saved to my favorite, so I confused myself for a second. I was like, did I totally make up this combo in my head? But I did not. So here we go. This is Fortune Cookie. They feel like we're on a little bit of gloss overload, but I see the cuteness. Do you guys see it? It's giving a little bit of a 90s lip, a little blot. A little blot never hurt nobody. Okay. Mm-hmm. Just trying to find the balance of how much lip liner to lip gloss. I think that's like personal preference. Wherever you wanna stop the blend, you know. Some people have more gloss. Some people have less gloss. I'm sure most of you have tried the butter glosses right now, but they're just your standard gloss. It's not sticky at all. There I go with my peely lips per usual. Yeah. She's cute. Mm-hmm. Really goes with our monochrome vibe right now from the other products. We don't have any highlight on, and you know, I would like some highlight. So just quickly going to do that before our final remarks. This is the other side of the Oma Beauty stick. Just placing that on our nose. Chin. So this is our final look and I'm ready to give you guys some final grades. I thought it over and we got a lot of B's today. So let's start off with our Sonia Kashuk sponge. I think the value's great, the material, the density, all good. Packaging is nothing to, you know, praise, but nothing bad either. And it blended well. Will it be a pain in the butt to wash something this large? Likely, but I mean, that just comes with the territory. I don't think it's something that is a holy grail for me, but it's not bad. So I'm gonna give this a B+. Again, you can find it at Target and I'll have it linked off down below. And I know my real ones already use my link, but if you would like to be a real one as well, they are always in the info box and it helps support the channel. And y'all know I appreciate you guys for that. Next up would be our Rare Beauty Finds. So the actual product and the actual TikTok we were talking about is the liquid eyeshadow in Nearly Neutral. I really like the shade. I really like the monochrome look we came out with today. The formulation, really good. Packaging, really good. Not mad at the price either. Overall, this is an A product to me. Like, girl, go off. Liquid eyeshadow, bomb. And it feels so good on. I mean, like, nothing. It doesn't come off. Wow. Like, this is mind-blowing. So I would say if you like any of those shades, run out, grab some, because I know they're gonna sell like hotcakes. For the coordinating blush in Nearly Neutral, she is a softer gal, like they claim, but she blended beautifully. She didn't cause any lines. Her packaging, very adorable and effective. And I do like that they have like a more of an imprint so your finger can slide into it. It doesn't get all up in your nails. And you know, they made sure they had that little dip in it. Really just thoughtful touches. Overall, I don't think it's going to be a super, super strong blush. So it might take a little bit, you know, more attention because like I said, the formulation is softer, but not bad. I'm gonna give it an A-. I don't feel like an A is what it is, but an A- seems to be more, like it settles on my soul a little better. So A- it is. I am quite excited. Though I did not have the best experience with their foundation and concealer, which I've already reviewed compared to other people, I'm very excited to see where Rare Beauty goes because I can tell that they're trying to do things just a little different. And I appreciate that. I'm intrigued. All right, girl. This mascara, she's probably the lowest grade of the day, but not a bad one. I'm gonna give her a B minus because I've seen better within Maybelline's line for my lashes. It's not bad. It's just not great. Like, it's not transferring. It's not super hard. It is on the drier side, but I am the type to like more of a wet formulation, and I'm not equipped with the lashes to give you the most dramatic before and after. So she is still above average because I've definitely had worse on my lashes from many brands, but a B minus is where I'm settling. Last but not least, we have our lip... Oh, this is an eyeliner. I mean, last but not least, we have our lip combo of the day. And I would wear this again. I'm pretty happy with it. It's very affordable. I don't think it's anything crazy, so I'm gonna give it an A minus. I feel like that fits for me. I wish the lip liner was a little creamier, and then it'd probably get like a flat A for me. But otherwise, if you're in Ulta, you're in CVS, you're in Target, and you wanna grab this duo, go ahead, girl. I've seen it on so many skin tones now that I think it works really, really well for a lot of them. And it, you know, it's cute. She's a dry lip approved because of the gloss. And overall, don't we love an affordable, like, everyday lip combo? Absolutely, we do. In this house, in this channel, here. I think that's it for us today. It felt kind of quick, but I'm glad we got to try these products together. Thank you guys so, so much for watching. I will be back with a drugstore wear test very, very soon. I hope you guys have been enjoying the January uploads and staying strong, positive, sane, and healthy. My recent uploads will be on the screen right now if you want to hang out on my channel for a little bit longer, support it, check out my, you know, recent videos. And my subscribe button's right here, so if you want to click that, she's free 99, you can join our fam. That's it for me today. Thank you guys again, and I will see you guys in a later video.